Hi, this is Mayor Farrakhan, and with today's Chat with the Mayor, I'm here with Barbara Reynolds of the eBell Club of Irvine. Well, thank you, Barbara, for making time to meet with me today. I'm so excited to learn more about the eBell group and what you do. So let's start off with you just sharing, what do you do with this organization?
This year, I'm treasurer. A couple years ago, I was president. I've been a variety. We're a small group. And so those of us who are willing to take on leadership roles do a lot of office trading. But the group itself was founded back in 1974 here in Irvine. It's part of the General Federation of Women's Club, which is an international organization, and we're like a local chapter. Well, there were about 10 members at the beginning, and at one point, the club grew to about 25 members. But we have whittled down now because we're kind of an aging population. And we have trouble finding new members. There are so many volunteer opportunities in Irvine and in Orange County now. And so finding people who are willing to volunteer their time for our kinds of activities is kind of a challenge. We work in a multiple of areas. There are like six dominant areas that the Federation defines for us. We work in education, we work in health areas, we work with other organizations such as the city when we can. One of our projects that's been ongoing since 2006 is purchasing botanical signs for the Jeffrey Open Space Trail.
Right.
And I think that's how our members kind of met you on that day, on the Love Irvine Day.
Yes. And they were telling me, and I had never realized it. I've seen the signs, but never realized where they came from.
Yeah.
So it's wonderful to know that there's actually a group behind it.
We've got 74 signs out there right now. We're quite proud of that.
Yes,
and
absolutely.
We're working on more.
That's wonderful. So share with me a little bit about some of the projects that you're currently working on.
I would say one of our large projects is our small quilts for human options. Human Options, as you probably know, is headquartered here in Irvine, and they work with victims of domestic violence. And so one of the things that we do are make these small quilts, and I brought one to show.
Love to see it.
Let me pull this out. Over the years that we've been doing this project, we have probably now made about 800 quilts for them. This year we're on target to produce 120 quilts. We were able to do that thanks to a partnership with the Tustin Exchange Club. About 4 years ago, we developed a relationship with them, and they donate annually to buy materials for us. So our combined efforts are allowing us to make 120 of these quilts this year.
That's amazing. I love them. They're wonderful. Well, hopefully people that are watching this episode that are interested in sewing will reach out and participate.
That would be very welcome. We'd love that. We'd love that.
And what else are you guys working on?
Our affiliation with Families Forward is also one that we donate to their food bank periodically. Right now in the summer, we're collecting school supplies from our members and anyone else who might want to help us to give to Families Forward for their summer backpack program.
And are you looking at like paper, color, crayons?
All of those things.
Well, tell me this. What are some of the things that you'd like to highlight that you guys have done in the past that you're just exceptionally proud of?
Well, when you drive around the streets of Irvine, you will see the blue dots periodically marking where the fire hydrants are. The eBell Club of Irvine back in the early 70s brought that project to Irvine and worked with the fire department. And while we funded the initial blue dots that they put down for us, they have since taken over that project and they fund it out of their own budget. But we're proud to have started that. Another long-term project is the Angel Tree. Now that reaches down into Ensenada, Mexico, to St. Teresa's Orphanage and School, okay? It's a Catholic organization operated by the sisters. One of our members, her parents adopted a child from there. And that child grew up as Diane's sister. And so she's always had a long-term interest. So each Christmas time, we reach into the community with our angel tree. We collect between 130 and 150 gifts, take them down to the orphanage, have a celebration, typically the second weekend of December. And so it's the generousness of our community that provides these gifts. We could never afford to buy all of these with our small budget. So we count on Irvine residents, and every year they come through and they provide us with gifts and then always a couple extra, because somehow we haven't gotten every child's name ahead of time that's going to show up for the party. And so you have to have a few backup presents so no one goes away disappointed.
That's wonderful. I mean, I love all the stuff that you guys do and have been doing for many, many years. So tell me, how can someone get a hold of the organization and you if they wanted to get more involved?
We do have a website. It's the ebellclubofirvine.shutterfly.com. And so we keep that up to date with contact information for our membership director. Or they can contact me and I can put them in touch with them. Happy to have them, however, whether they want to become a member or whether they just hear something they'd like to support, any of that would definitely be welcome news and contact.
Barbara, I wanted to thank you so much for taking the time to come out and chat with me and share about all the great work with the eBell organization.
Thank you.
Really appreciate it. And so with that, any last final words before we wrap up?
Just, I've been thrilled to meet you, get to know you firsthand instead of just hear about you here and there. And it's been a pleasure to be a part of this endeavor.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.